Welcome to Mint. I'm Amrit Raj, and in today's edition of From the Newsroom, we have with us Mint's Kolkata Bureau Chief, Mr. Anik Paul. Hi, Anik.
Hi.
We also have with us Mr. Raghunath, a Delhi-based independent media consultant. Welcome to the show, Mr. Raghunath.
Thank you.
We are here to discuss the price war which is being opened by the Times of India Group and the ABP Group in West Bengal in the vernacular dailies. The Times of India Group has said that it will be launching a Bengali newspaper. And the subscription for that paper would be available at 175 rupees for 6 months. In order to challenge it, the ABP Group has said that it will be launching a tabloid, which would be available for 6 months at only rupees 150. So we are here to discuss the aspects related to this issue. My first question would be to Anik. Anik, how do you think it is going to change the competition in the vernacular dailies in West Bengal?
Clearly, the fight currently is between two new products, and two new products had to come into the market because vendors wouldn't, as I mentioned, vendors wouldn't have taken kindly to a cut in their commission. So one could get into the price war only by creating additional income or revenue for the vendors. That has already happened. Now is the question of how the two organizations absorb the cost. Clearly, Bennett Coleman and Company Limited is a much stronger organization financially than ABP Private Limited. Well, it is to be seen how they adapt to this change, how other newspapers adapt to this change. Some are planning to add some new pages, but clearly the challenge is to expand into new homes with these two very new products, and they are essentially aimed at, it appears as of now, to be aimed at the urban youth, people who are moving or switching from Bengali newspapers to English newspapers.
Right. Mr. Raghunath, my question to you would be, do you think this price war is going to be effective? Is it going to work at all in the state of West Bengal? And if at all it does, whom would it favor?
Okay. See, the West Bengal was the only market where the number one daily or the traditional conventional setup which existed there has not been challenged like it had been done, say, in Punjab or Gujarat or Andhra Pradesh. So the reader has stayed very comfortably in its comfort zone. There was a brand that, like, there was Amrit Baja Patrika, which was, of course, a formidable competition to Anandaya Patrika. That was pretty long time ago. But then after, of course, anybody who came and challenged ABP had remained all the time a very distant number two. Now, if I look into the Bengal, the domain per se, although the 72% of the Bengali population can read Bengali, but if you look at the numbers, the all Bengali dailies put together only reach 22% of the Bengali reading audience. You know, so there I see a huge potential for any daily to come up, structure their price, put the content properly, and market it. So I see, of course, there is a huge potential for any daily to come and occupy and challenge the leader there and occupy a good number two slot.
Anik, how do you think it is going to impact other players in the market who are probably not as stronger as a brand as compared with these two?
Well, first of all, on the advertisement tariff front, I would say that Times of India will not be able to determine advertisement tariff for Bengali newspaper for at least 2 to 3 years. That's what experts in Calcutta say.
Right.
And that's because it's going to take that amount of time to build its readership to be able to determine advertisement tariffs for Bengali newspapers.
Right.
Well, however, as I mentioned before, that all newspapers are trying to rediscover themselves. All newspapers are trying to expand into new homes. And to do that, Anand Bazar, for instance, announced a tabloid. Other newspapers are looking to add pages, maybe redesign their pages, redesign the look and feel of the newspapers to be able to capture, to be able to retain, or to be able to get into new homes. People essentially switching, or those people who are switching from Bengali newspapers to English newspapers.
There seems to be an interesting battle being panning out in the state of West Bengal. While Times of India would be putting all its financial muscle into the battle, ABP would expect its readers to be loyal to them. Only the time will tell what is going to happen in the state. Thank you for joining us, Anik.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Raghunath.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
That's all from the newsroom right now. Keep watching. Stay tuned.